Lumos.
By my own allies. I don't expect to have the plot of my plans unraveled by the very people who stand next to me.
Revelio. Lumos.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. It took the cunning of a Slytherin to track down these pages.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school.
Aside from the birdbath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed.
Lumos.
A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path
Lumos.
And keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath.
Accio! Levioso!
Or Greek.
The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word. Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is. Just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Revelio. Lumos.
How nice it is. Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. But,
a risk those loyalists will report back to Ranrok now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
Lumos!
I wonder how big this place is.
Revelio! Lumos.
Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this. I'm not going to touch those. Ugh.
Levioso, Accio. Revelio.
That platform ought to be able to float straight to you.
Revelio. Levioso. Accio. Expelliarmus. Incendio.
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Levioso. Accio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Another puzzle. Well, if Jackdaw could solve this, so can I.
Revelio. Revelio.
It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Accio!
Stupid one.
Incendio.
Untouched chest. Terrador wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Revelio! Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this. An untouched chest. Terrador wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Accio!
There it is. The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. These can't be what the hell are you doing?
Leviosa. Accio.
Stupid.
Leviosa. Expelliarmus.
Only imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way.
Revelio! Revelio!
To look around for the symbol. I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is, the map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Expelliarmus. Retainer. Accio.
Levioso!
Accio! Expelliarmus! Incendio! Expelliarmus! Incendio! Incendio! Levioso! Expelliarmus!
What? That's unnerving. What's happening?
Revelio.
I've seen this before. Gringotts and the restricted section.
Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this?
I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here.
What is this place?
Can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention, and might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book, right?
Good. We shall.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
Revelio.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started.
Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome.
Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it? Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up, firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty schoolgroom!
Up!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece. Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
Made it! Oh, did anyone else see that?
Ah, oh, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year.
Whoa! Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Ha! Good. I've got this.
I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Slytherin like you might be interested in making an escape from class?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now.
Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever.
Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today.
Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead of the gardens,
The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part Hippogriff?
There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Let's hurry back. And hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I'm disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still... Because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good fly.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps. I could show her a thing or two if I had my...
Perhaps I have to purchase a broom.
If you can. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always... I'll keep an eye out...
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Welcome.
do let me know if I can be of any assistance.
Rebellion.
What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you. Very good. Never hurts to keep my stocks replenished. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Excellent.
What are you up to now?
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
Off to you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you've found it.
Revelio.
There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away.
Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on those chairs. Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on.
Lumos.
Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. I can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Dear me. Can't you keep it down? Some of us are trying to rest.
Lumos.
Leviosa.
Hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
An intruder! Stop them! Oh, not... that's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here?
Revelio.
What was that? Was that a golden snitch?
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
Lumos.
Accio. Revelio. Accio.
Incendio.
Thank you.
Revelio.
Leviosa.
Accio. Incendio.
I hope that house elf can find us in here.
Careful.
Huh?
Oh, there you are. Wait right there. Deke will come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke. We've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped.
It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map.
Deke's seen students in need of an extra file for potions. You seem to have accessed it.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes.
Oh, that explains it.
What I need specifically is a place where I can...
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed.
Thank you.
You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of descript...
It will. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring.
Conjuring?
Yes. The magic of creating or conjuring objects. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. You should have acquired some for a potion.
I did.
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained, they can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier.
I see.
You can in... Why don't you give it a try? You should find both familiar, since they'll resemble the ones you've already used.
Revelio.
Well done. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Deke will be here to answer any questions.
I will be...
Good.
I'm ready for the next lesson.
Very well. First, you can acquire it by vanishing items here in the Room of Requirement, or you can get... Return to me once...
I have the moonstone.
Good. You can conjure more... Conjuration can be used. Why don't you try it on?
You should be proud of all the potions you've brewed. Beasts you have here. Things. You should be proud of all the potions you've brewed. Deke hasn't seen this many plants here before. Believe how many beasts you have here.
Good work. Shall we move on?
I've conjured everything I can. What's next, Professor?
I think you're ready to take on alteration. The altering spell will allow you to customize any conjured item. You can change the colors, patterns, and styles of your furniture to suit your taste. Let's get started, shall we? Watch closely as I demonstrate how to perform the altering spell. Just aim your wand at any item and perform the altering spell.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed. Thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
It warms my heart to see your interest in herbology, dare I say. Blossom.
Dee cannot believe how many beasts you have here.
Nicely done. Now you're ready for something a little more advanced. You can use the altering spell directly on the room's architecture. Try these new designs on the floor or balcony. Your space might benefit from a bit of ambiance, don't you think? Deke, would you mind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. Professor Weasley showed Deke this bit of magic some years ago. Deke thinks you'll enjoy it. Come and talk to Deke when you're ready. Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Professor Weasley said I should ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to feel mysterious and eerie, as if I'm in the Forbidden Forest.
surrounded by shadows.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Quite a difference. Of course, you needn't keep this style if you don't like it. You can always ask Deke to change it back. Now you have learned a good bit about alteration.
Thank you, Professor. The room is full of possibilities.
Indeed. No matter how much time I spend here, the room always manages to surprise me. Space.
How did that happen?
The room equips itself to your needs. It must have sensed that you needed more space to practice spellcasting. If you'd like to customize the space further, you can use these spellcrafts.
Thank you.
Good. I'll leave you.
Thank you.
How are your assignments coming along?
I completed yours.
Good. Concentrate. Do not let your mind wander. You've got it now. If you'd like to practice, and I think you should, perhaps best not to go flinging your classmates about the halls. I suggest having a go at the enchanted books here.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Over here.
Sebastian, it's been a while.
It has. Glad you received.
First, let me thank you.
Of course. Scribner tried to give me detention.
Well, you took the fall for me.
Did you find what you were looking for?
I did. But something was missing. I'm not sure here is the best place to discuss it.
Understood. We can talk more in a moment, in the Undercroft. Not even the professors know about this place.
This way.
There's a secret passage just here.
It's well disguised. How did you find this place?
My friend, Ominous Lumos. Ault. He named it the Undercroft. We used to play Gobstones here all the time. With my sister.
Rebellion.
She loved that infernal game. What I wouldn't give to lose to her again. I should tell you, I swore to Ominous I would safeguard this place. So please, keep it between us. He never confides in anyone. But he's trusted me since the day we met. I wouldn't want to jeopardize that. We used to sneak in here almost daily. We've never been caught.
I know Ominous. Met him in our common room. I've noticed he uses his wand to navigate the castle.
He does. No idea how, though. Ominous was born blind, and no spell could reverse it. His wand seems almost sentient. Not surprising, I suppose.
Is that how he found this?
No, someone in his family knew about it. I've never heard anyone else speak of it. Again, mention this to no one, especially Ominous.
Of course. Ominous spoke to me about his family.
Glad you understand.
Really? Like what?
Like the blasting curse. Professors say it's not an appropriate...
A proper magical education ought to include all magic.
My thoughts exactly. To be fair, I'm admittedly... But you should learn it. It may take a while to get the feel for it. Mimic my wand movement. The incantation is Confringo.
Very well.
You're getting it. Ready to actually try it out? Stick to the targets, though. Best to keep the Undercroft intact. Have a go at those candelabras. Both have their uses, but I think you'll find that a Confringo cast travels a bit farther than that of a spell like Incendio.
Confringo!
Nice work. How's it feel? That's it.
I think I've got it.
Well done.
I have to say, I enjoyed that.
The first time Ominous and I practiced Confringo, we singed our eyebrows.
I would have paid to see that.
I swore we'd never live it down. So this day, there's something about that spell that's addictive.